2014 was another warm year across most of Australia. It was our third warmest year on record, with a mean temperature about 0.9 degrees above average. It was particularly warm in the south, where regions shaded dark orange notched up their highest mean temperatures since 1910, when national records began. Most of Australia experienced temperatures very much above average, as shown by the lighter orange shading. The yellow areas recorded above average temperatures. In contrast, the blue area in the Northern Territory had below average temperatures. We certainly had a hot start to the year, with severe heat waves hitting the south and the east in mid-January. Unseasonable warmth extended late into autumn, with a long run of days in May that were 6 to 8 degrees warmer than average. Winter did make a brief appearance, as vigorous cold fronts in the southeast brought rain, snow and strong winds in late June. A cold snap marked the start of August, with record low overnight temperatures across southeastern Australia, bringing severe frost and crop damage to inland areas and heavy snow in alpine regions. We then experienced our warmest spring on record. October's maximum temperatures were 2.76 degrees above average, and November was record-breaking for both maximum and mean temperatures. The unusual warmth contributed to an early start of the fire season. In November, fires threatened houses in the Blue Mountains, and a heat wave combined with gusty winds sparked a brief spate of bush and grass fires in Queensland and New South Wales. While national rainfall for the year was near average, it was drier than average in the southwest and for much of the east. Areas of pink and red had below average rainfall. In parts of Queensland, New South Wales, Victoria and Tasmania, deficiencies have been increasing and water storage levels dropping. Long-term drought conditions persist in central and southern Queensland. Parts of the north and much of Western Australia got more rain than usual. Summer storms at the start of the year contributed to above-average rainfall in blue areas. El Niño can have a big impact on our climate, and since autumn this year, we've seen ocean and atmospheric conditions generally close to El Niño levels. These conditions have contributed to the warmer temperatures and reduced rainfall in the south and the east. So, looking back at 2014, it was another very warm year, punctuated with widespread heat waves. 7 of Australia's 10 warmest years have occurred since 2002, and the year just passed adds to the evidence of a long-term warming trend. For the Bureau of Meteorology, I'm Neil Plummer.